Hey guys, Drew here with Smokecraft Barbecue. I'm here to really quickly show you how to do a perfect turning box for your KCBS competitions. A lot of teams are using kale and parsley, but I find that takes a lot of time. So we use green leaf lettuce, and I'm gonna show you something that's gonna save you so much time, you're gonna thank me later. If you look at the clock behind me, it's almost 11 o'clock in the morning. So you can know that I can do this fast if I'm waiting until 11 a.m. the day of turnings to do it. So this is my last box. I've already done three of them, but what we're gonna do today, I'm gonna quickly show you. So we take a nice head of green leaf lettuce, make sure you get something that's nice and crisp. You're gonna roll it up in your saran wrap, nice and tight like a cigar. Twist the tops to get it nice and tight, and the bottom. Now, what we're gonna do from here is we're gonna slice this into some pieces, and then we're gonna put them around and pull out the plastic that is holding it, and it's gonna fill in the box really nicely. Now, when we decide to do this, first thing you always want to do, look at your boxes that your judges gave you. Today, our boxes are a little bit shallow. Sometimes you get boxes that are a little bit deeper, and that determines how thick you want to cut this. For brisket or chicken, you may want to have a higher base so your food stands out, but for chicken and ribs, you want lower so it doesn't hit the top. Pork, you may want that higher base so it stands out. So today, I've already done three boxes, and I always decide what I'm going to use at the end on how all my boxes look. But I'm gonna take my slicing knife, and I've got my disposable cutting board here. First thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take off the top about 1.5 to 2 inches. I'm just gonna slice it straight off. It's too loose, but you can see how it's nice and tight, and that's what we're looking for in the inside here with the rest of these slices. So we're gonna cut these about 3/8 of an inch to 1/2 inch thick, and you're gonna go all the way through. Make sure you cut it all the way through so you don't have kind of hangnails with plastic. Same thing with your brisket, don't make that mistake. Cut your brisket all the way through. And you're gonna cut 4 or 5 of these depending on how thick your head of green leaf is. This one's a little bit thinner, and so I know from experience I'm gonna probably need 5, so I went ahead and just cut 5 so I have them. But you can see how they're nice and tight. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna place these around the inside of my box, and if I got them, any of them thicker or any of them leaning one way, which it doesn't look like I did, I'll put those in the back so it's the food's angled upwards and use it as a prop. But here, it looks like we got perfect sizes here, so we're gonna go ahead and pull out the plastic. Just kind of reach in, get your finger around the edge of that plastic, and when you roll these up, never use two pieces of plastic. Always do it as one continuous piece of plastic because you wanna be able to pull this off. If you do multiple pieces, you could accidentally leave a piece of plastic in your box. See, the whole thing is out. If you leave plastic in your box doing this, you will get disqualified. So make sure you get that plastic out. Some teams use colored saran wrap who do this to make sure that they can see it. I don't have any colored saran wrap today, otherwise I'd show it to you. But we're pretty comfortable doing this. We've never had a problem pulling out plastic here. So again, you just pull it out, hold your finger to the edges of that lettuce as you pull it around to make sure it stays nice and tight in the box. And usually what I do is I can do all, if I have to do five pieces like this, I will pull out the plastic on the corners first and kind of push everything wide. Okay, and let all push wide. And don't worry about a piece or two that pops up with your plastic. You know, with this process, you know, we're gonna have plenty of lettuce to choose from here. Okay, so again, make sure you get the whole thing out. All right, and so I got that last little piece here. So this last little piece is gonna push out those edges, and the whole box is gonna be really nice and tight. Again, just be carefully pull it out so you don't accidentally rip it off and leave any plastic in the box. All right, so all my plastic's out. So you can see here, got a couple pieces of lettuce sticking out. So I'm not too worried about that because my food's gonna cover the middle. So I'm most worried about the edges. You wanna make sure your edges are down nice and tight against the box, that where you have these little gaps here, you kind of pull it together to make sure you don't get those gaps. Make sure you get your corners because those are the parts that are exposed. Now remember, you're not supposed to get judged on your garnish, but you never know, it's a game of inches out there. So you wanna make sure that this looks good. But essentially, that's it. You can see how quick and easy that was, and I got a really nice solid base that I can put my food on top of today, and it's gonna hold that food up. I don't have to worry about pressing it down. I don't have to worry about putting other stuff on top of it. These little small pieces in the middle, you know, you can pick them out so they don't stick to your food, but for the most part, it looks like they're tight and down. So I'm pretty good with that box. So what I'm gonna do last step is I'm gonna quickly take 4 half sheets of paper towel and just rip them apart. Take a bottle of water, never use sink water, because this is now your food, your turn-in box. Gotta squeeze that water in so you get the whole thing all wet. And I'm gonna take these 4, and what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna fold them on top, put them on top here to make sure that you're keeping this lettuce nice and crisp as I put this back in the fridge until I'm ready to use it. And then what I'll do when I set up my actual box for later is I will take these pieces of paper, wet paper towel, and I'll put one on each edge of the box to make sure I don't get any sauce in the box as I'm transferring my meat that's all sauce into it. And then so carefully close your box, make sure you don't knock your tabs, and that's it. So you can see I made this box in 5 minutes. So I can do all 4 of my boxes if I'm going at speed and not talking about it in 15 to 20 minutes, which is why I always do it the morning of. I have these leftover pieces of lettuce here for my things. I'll save these in case I crack a box and I need to quickly put another one together until the very end. But I hope you guys learned something today. Great luck out there on the competition trail. I hope this saves you some time. You don't have to worry about that kale and parsley getting all over the place. And good luck to you. We'll see you next time.